must be hungry. We'll get you something to eat soon, my little Percy. Oh, hello. Did Stino let you in? Excellent. I do apologize if she gave you a fright. My sisters are rather more monstrous looking than I, but they have kind hearts if you know them well. And of course, if you're not a threat, get on their bad side, and I suppose they could be rather dangerous, but the same can be said of me. Well, regardless, I'm very glad you made it here safely. Granted, the journey isn't nearly as treacherous as it used to be. I'd say you had it quite easy. Oh, you should have seen it back in the ancient days. By sea, the Trojan sea monster, sent by Poseidon himself. It was revenge, you see. He was cheated out of his promised payment for building the great walls of Troy, and slain by Hercules himself. And then, by land, you had the Maeonian dragon, which had to be slain twice before it died. You see, its mate, it couldn't really accept that its beloved had been killed, and therefore it procured a potion of some kind and brought it back to life once again. But all those horrors and wonders are gone from the world now. And thus you arrived in one piece. So I suppose it is a happy thing. He's wonderful, is he not? Heard in quite a while. Well, of course, I've slain my fair share of heroes in my time, but I can't help but have some sort of respect for them too. They only aim to make the world a better place, after all, with a slice of fame on the side. But anyway, my point is, we live in different times now, hence why I renovated my cave to make it a little more cozy. Do you like it? Yes, well, my sisters and I, we were born in humble beginnings, and a cave suited us rather well, but it's not exactly ideal for hosting guests. Ah, speaking of which, where are my manners? Would you like some tea? Alright. One for me. And one for you. Oh, this type of tea is enjoyed without milk, generally. Although I do tend to add something a little special to mine. Ambrosia. Drink of the gods. It's a little like honey, so I could get you some of that if you'd like. This is, in fact, what gives the gods immortality. And it makes the drink delicious, too. Yes, a few few drinks of this and the blood running in your veins will turn to golden ichor. Oh, I'm afraid I wouldn't be able to give it to you. The gods guard their secrets jealously, and I'm already on shaky ground since I suppose I wasn't the ideal candidate for immortality. Well, a little for me, and would you like me to fetch you some honey? Very well. It is delicious as it is. Now, we can finally get to know each other. In all of the stories, after all. Well, stories of my death were greatly exaggerated. You see, part of the tale is true. Perseus was indeed tasked with bringing my head. He was given special shoes from Hermes, special sword from Athena. All types of things, really, to get the job done. But then he arrived. He met me, saw I was rather reasonable, and could kill him at a glance. So, we sat down, much like we are now, with my mirror. We talked over tea, and decided it would be better for both of us if we simply went our separate ways. Well, that way he didn't have to risk his life. He claimed glory for my death. And in return, I stopped having heroes coming to bother me at every hour of the day and night. I didn't enjoy the killing, you know. It was just a necessity, which then stopped after Perseus. I did imbue his shield with some of my powers, and I did have to say goodbye to my darling pet Pegasus. I still miss him, but it was a small price to pay for what I got out of it. That's what my darling is named after, you see. Perseus did me a great boon. So, I suppose little Percy here is my way of remembering him. So there you have it. Why I'm still alive. What about you? What's your life? I suppose if you wanted, you could come and live with me for a while, see what it's like. The island we live on is rather large, and me and my sisters possess magic enough to provide food with ease. Oh, and I still have a decent amount of riches. Learn a thing or two over the millennia I've been alive. We could spend our days exploring the forests, swimming in the warm sea, and at night sit down by the fire with some wine and some good food and chat away. It's a simple enough life, but one that I very much enjoy, and have never tired of, even though I've been doing it for quite a while. Or, alternatively, I suppose I could come and visit you every now and then. Oh, please forgive me if I seem rather forward. I suppose, in my situation, the opportunity of love does not present itself very often, and I find it's best to grab onto such things with both hands when they present themselves. Of course, feel free to say no and sail away once again. I'm not going to turn around and turn you to stone or anything. Ah, I believe that's something else I should mention. You see, while I can, and have before, accidentally turned people into stone who I did not wish to be permanent statues, I have in my many years discovered a solution. Well, there is a cure, but understandably that's information I keep close to my chest, so I would appreciate it if you didn't spread that around lightly. There is a witch, a friend of mine, named Circe, an island far away called Aiaia. I don't venture there often, unless I have need to, but she has a talent with a very special plant called moly. It only sprouts where Titan blood has been spilled on the earth. And this wonderful little plant has the ability, when brewed correctly by someone of her talents, to reverse transformations such as the one caused by my little talent. I thought you should know, if you were going to spend more time with me, there is a plan, should I fail to protect you. So, I suppose you came here willing to take the risk. After all, coming all the way out to my island to reject me when you'd already done such a thing at our little event would be quite cruel of you, don't you think? Well, it is a pleasant surprise. Mortals never fail to amaze me at their bravery. I am glad, though, and I look forward to spending more time with you. But first, you should come and meet my sisters. I promise you'll warm to them. And I think this little arrangement calls for a feast. I will prepare the most wonderful spread. You'll be blown away.
Welcome to the Monster Mash, the speed dating extraordinaire for the paranormal.
Video games. Interesting.
So how would you explain your personality? Are you strong, courageous, ready to go battle, can lead an army of skeletons?
That's so much better. Oh, goodness. You have no idea how heavy my thoughts are sometimes. You know what I mean?
What, me? Oh, I'm a Barnard Fair shaper. You know, hairdresser. Yeah. It's an interesting profession.
I try my best to be careful, but accidents do happen. Well, if it helps, I take very good care of my statues.
I often do work well alone. But every few hundred years or so, I get lonely. And I need people to see me for who I really am.
Well, you see, my husbands, they seem to mysteriously disappear from time to time. I don't quite know why. I mean, you've probably heard some rumors about me, but they are all not true.
Of course, it should be warned that the reanimation of corpses can be a little shocking for some.
I kicked it in 1985. Yeah, walking home from the movies. The Breakfast Club. You heard of it?